Of course, now I have another one in India. I'm asking my Lord, will you allow me to see the Yamuna front entirely restored to its pristine, glorious beauty of Lord Krishna's Lila? Of course, Lord Krishna's Lila doesn't need anything. The deity of Lord Krishna is beautiful enough, but we should not have a neglect in the holy Dham. I feel we should not have dirt and we should not have neglect in the holy Dham. So I made it kind of a self-assigned project that before I leave this world, I want the Yamuna to be a pristine, glorious place. Now we see how long I will be allowed to participate there and to see it. Already we have one accomplishment. We have not celebrated it yet in Germany. That was the removal of the 9 pillars in the Yamuna, which were like the ugliest thing ever. So those pillars are removed, and that was even by the antagonistic government. We got the antagonistic government, well, not really antagonistic, but they had other agendas. So, but we got them to remove those pillars. Now the favorable government, which is now in power, we should get them to get the Yamuna to look. It's not only the Yamuna, it's also the management of all the black waters of Mathura, 2 million people, of Vrindavan, 200,000 people, of Delhi, 20 million people. So there are quite some tasks, but we must know that the government itself has taken Ganga and Yamuna issue as top priority. Now we will see what top priority will come to bring for us. But this is good. We are in good times, the best times ever. Even they appointed a very dynamic yogi to be the chief minister of Uttar Pradesh. I think that's the first time in history that a yogi became the chief minister of a state. And Uttar Pradesh has more people living there than the whole United States of America. It's the biggest state in India, Uttar Pradesh. And the Uttarakhand, which is the next state, Himalaya state, is also of the same political party completely. So the Uttarakhand now is 100% Dharmic. And plus, with Yogi Adityanath, we send in all your blessings to this gentleman, because he has a lot of pressure on him, big pressure from the Muslim world, everybody looking at him, because there was a big conflict with the Ram Mandir, because they made a mosque where Lord Ramchandra's temple was. So naturally every Hindu wants that mosque removed and the Ram temple to be put there. But it became a political issue in the time of the Congress government, no support for the Hinduism and the Muslims. They started attacking Hindu temples all around. It became like a civil war type of situation. So therefore, it was stopped then. Let's see how Yogi Adityanath will manage it. I think he is a very capable person. And we'll see. We'll see that will be part of, I mean, rather, it really doesn't matter, you know. It's a question of national pride also, and to eradicating the influences of colonialism from India. So I also think it should be done. But you know, Lord Ram, he is worshipped in so many temples. Lord Ram is the Supreme Lord, and Ayodhya is his city. It's not a Muslim city, it's not. But you know, the Muslims were very powerful in that area. They changed the name from Prayag to Allahabad and things like that, you know. they had a big influence there, and there was a very horrible past. But now we have Hindutva. We have the defense of the original. To my opinion, the independence of India was achieved 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago. Because at the time of the Congress government and everything with the Indian, they had so many obligations by the British put, so many restrictions dividing India, Pakistan, Bangladesh. It wasn't the real independence. And as far as the educational system is concerned, they still have not achieved the independence. Even though now we have some universities like Patanjali University, which is independent from the system. So we even in the level of high educational in concern, there are good news. Also, I wanted to say for those, we had a little discussion of veganism or versus vegetarian, lacto-vegetarian philosophy. We know that the vegans, they are the most wonderful people. They really want to protect the cows to the maximum and don't want to put them into any anxiety. We sympathize with that. We understand them. But Patanjali has saved us by creating the biggest cow protection project in the history of this planet Earth, financed by a huge enterprise of Ayurveda and natural consumers around India. I don't know how many outlets Patanjali has, but maybe something like 50,000. They have an outlet everywhere in every street. And people understand when we consume their products, we are helping our Vedic culture to come back on the ground. And their goshalas, places of cow protection, of that type, that they keep the price of the milk products on a competitive level with other companies, even though protected cow, happy cow milk and ghee is much more expensive to produce. But what they did, I spoke with the CEO, Acharya Balkrishna, a wonderful person. When you meet the person, you almost fall instantly in love with that guy. He's such a unique character and real yogi, real practitioner. So Balkrishna, he told me, we are spending the profits of our company to make sure these cows are protected. So I didn't have time to visit their cow protection installations because I was in the university, I met with them, and there we also spoke about influencing South America with their energies and ideas, and we're looking forward. We already started something now, but it was because I got so many projects in India simultaneously, so I also couldn't point, but at least one thing is, you need ghee, you want to use ghee for cooking or for anything, get it from Patanjali Ghee. Have a few boxes shipped over, and then you can very safely say this ghee is from happy cows, and we can consume it, and we can offer it to the deity, so that we have some relief. And they're doing it. It's a social service. By using their profits to take care of those cows, they are providing a great social service to return to Gorakshya, to return to cow protection in the world, which is only possible if powerful people like them actually put it into action. Mahatma Gandhi said, only the government can make sure that Gorakshya actually works. So now the government is giving support to Patanjali and to a few others. I mean, they're not the only ones protecting cows. There's Yogi Rajendra, who has something like 200,000 cows. Ramesh Baba has plenty of cows. So there's other efforts. We also have a little Goshala in Govardhan, in Radhakunda. It is called the Vrinda Goshala, and that has 200 cows. And these cows are definitely protected. Our Lalita Malva is managing that Goshala and the finance to and the finances of that is in the name of one lady, a doctor, an NRI, a non-residential Indian from London. He's financing our Goshala. As a matter of fact, we are giving the facility, but it's nice. It's like one example. What we do generally is just smallish, because we don't have resources. So therefore we have a small school, a small Goshala, and a small little temple and a small cleaning project. But the cleaning project in India, we are trying to make it real and big now. Why? The reason for that is that after the pillars were destroyed, I had made a vow that we really want to substantially change the situation in the Holy Dham. And as I saw that we had some accomplishment, and I saw that our temples around the world, we are getting all the mercy from Radha and Krishna, all the mercy from Vrindavan. So why we should not give $100 a month to pay one worker in Vrindavan? So that means $100, I mean, Munich is already given it. They already took up that charge. Berlin will take it up. If now some of our temples are really poor, they are really nothing, they won't be able to do it. But Medellin and Bogota, and they can do that. So by getting this sponsorship of, let's say, 50 to 100 temples, I can already prepare a huge impact in Vrindavan of this through home guards or Bhumi guards. They are in the hot spots and overlooking that the high standard of what you expect to see in a holy place will be established and kept up. Vidai Chor is our man in Vrindavan training the home guards, and the home guard idea is accepted. I presented to the ministers in Delhi, I went to the district magistrate, I have a whole lot of ideas working, going on there. And then if we need 300 home guards to cover the entire Braj Mandal. We are designing for the government a project called the Braj Dhani. Braj Dhani is a take of the Chokki Dhani in Jaipur, the reassembly of an old Rajasthani village, or now Braj village, with all the implications of making something beautiful. I made some design, and when I spoke to the Minister of Culture of India just a few days ago, he told me, I accept your proposal that Braj Mandal and the parikrama of Braj Mandal should be elevated to a status of the World Heritage culture. So that is the second project I have been pushing for the last 30 years, that Braj Mandal has to be recognized as a World Heritage site in one way, because it's very big, you know. Braj Mandal is 3,000 villages are in there, you know. It's almost 5,000 square kilometers, you know. So So it's a huge place. So how to implicate such a thing was not clear to them. But by making the Braj Mandal Parikrama a World Heritage Culture Function, now Minister of Culture has accepted it. It's just a question of days or months or weeks that it will be officially announced. That's their job. Only the government can do the final draw. But they asked me for all the I wrote up the description. If you give me my block from there, I have a block there on my table. I will read you the letter which we wrote to the government and the World Heritage Committee, so that this will be accomplished. And as I told you, it's already approved. Now just the legal things to get it done are missing. And if the Braj Mandal Parikrama is recognized as a World Heritage Site, then the whole Braj Mandal will have to get a facelift, because they cannot have a World Heritage Site ignored. So we have the Taj Mahal is also a World Heritage Site, and they have made incredible laws. There's no more industries in Agra allowed to contaminate the area with chimneys of many things like that. So I am sure we are going to see many good developments coming from that. And because I identified with this, and I thought there was one of our Vrinda tasks, that's why I said, come on, let's come to our senses, let's participate. Because nobody can do it, but you know, $100 a month, I mean, even our Nimai Huset can afford it. Even they can say, yeah, we can do that. And even smaller places can afford it, especially in Europe where there's good economy. Or any individual say, yeah, I want to be part of that. And we will put their name on the uniform of the Home Guard. So our Home Guards are going to be, this one is sent from Czech Republic, this one is working for representing. So it'll be a really an international supported thing. I mean, listen, what is 300 people? 300 people in any company, that's peanuts. This is nothing compared to what you need to run. I'm pretty sure the Stadtverwaltung from Prenzlauer Berg has more than 300 employees. So it's really nothing. But that's another thing here. That was a WEA meeting. Looking for it. Then we also were in contact with the Minister of Yoga and Ayurveda of India, a wonderful gentleman, and we are working together with the Yoga Day. So please, in Berlin, make sure we are part of the Yoga Day organizers. Actually, here it is. A little confused here. Continued. That's the second part here. Second part. Yes. This is another thing. We're working with the Ministry of External Affairs. I wrote a letter to the minister to get better visas for our people when they come to India. So I'm working on many levels of the government to try to get something accomplished. I had a meeting with that external minister, but it was cancelled because she had a kidney failure, and she got a new kidney. So, but she's okay. United Nations of the Spirit in India. This is the plan of the Kiva in Kumbh Mela, 2019. February 2019, mark the day. There will be a Kiva going from Himalayas to Ganga Sagar with the abuelos from Abhyayala and with many people meeting with all the chiefs of the Hindu tradition. There's so many meetings here. Okay, here we go. Yeah, that was here we go. So Mr. Mahesh Sharma, the culture and tourist minister, he asked me to write up why we should have a World Heritage Site. Write up to support Churasi Coast Parikrama for World Heritage Introduction. In the Bhakti Ratnaka, it says Krishna started this Govardhan Parikrama himself, including the Sastanga Dandavat pranams, the worship of nature by having a total pranam, including to mountains, rivers, kundas, forests, and cows. After Krishna, who started that Govardhan Parikrama, Sri Brajanapa, the great grandson of Krishna, he was the second one to do parikrama, and he did it with Chandilya Muni, and Mother Rohini was giving advice what places to visit. Brajanapa, in his parikrama, he established four Naths: Govinda, Gopinath, Srinath, and the Madan Mohan. He established four Shivas: Bhuteshwara, Chakleshwara, Gopeshwara, Kameshwara. He established four Devis in Braj Mandal: Mansar Devi, Govardhan, Vrinda Devi, Vrindavan, Patal Devi, Mathura, and Yoga Maya in Radha Govinda Mandir. The Patal Devi is the Shakti Pita of India. It's an original place of where Devi's energy was given. The next parikrama was Uddhava. He was guided by the gopis to see the holy places connected with Krishna. In our presentation, the synergy of stakeholders are to be expounded. One is one operational plan from 2017 to 2042, one operative plan working 25 years, what kind of Braj we want to see in 25 years. There's an emphasis that there's a black stone, Kashavati, which is used for gold testing, which was used to make those deities, these Brajanap installed deities. Where Kamsa was killed, the children of Devaki it is said that they turned into these rocks. The deities were made from that. That's another amazing story. Then continued. Why do we do parikrama? Most vibrant living tradition dating back 5,000 years ago. There is no danger of extinction. There's no, that people would stop going to Govardhan. You can forget about that. 60 billion Tirthas exist in India. All of them visit Braj in Kartik, stated in the Varaha Purana. So if you're going there, you're just one amongst the billions of Tirthas. Prayag Tirtha has been mentioned to go to Pavan Sarova to get rid of the sins everybody leaves in Ganga when they are bathing in Ganga for getting rid of sins. That Prayag Tirtha comes to Pavan Sarova to get rid of the sins on him. That is the power of Braj. Dhruva Maharaj in Madhuvan has the Dhruva Tila in Satya Yuga. First king of India, Ambarish Maharaj, he was emperor of the world and he was ruling from Mathura. Vedavyas, Durvasa Muni and Narada Muni are all connected to Braj Mandal. Madhu Daitya founded Madhupuri, which became later Mathura. In Treta Yuga, Shatrunga, the brother of Sri Ram, established the Aryan civilization after the Asuras were defeated. Here you're going back into history. These are the Vedic histories as far as Mathura is concerned. Jain and Buddhist scriptures have mention of Braj Charosi Koshi Parikrama. Even other religions came and they gave respect to this. 14th century, Jain Prabhu Shuvi did parikrama. 15th century, Madhavendra Puripad did parikrama. 16th century, Nityananda Advaita did parikrama. Nimbarka Acharya also did parikrama in the beginning. 1519 AD, Swami Haridas did parikrama and brought Akbar and Tang Sen, their Jahangir, their important leaders of India of those days, they also came to do parikrama. This is the evidence why we should have a World Heritage Site, you know. This is researched work. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and re-established and rediscovered the glories of the Braj. Under his guidance, Lokanath Goswami, Bulgarba Goswami, then the six Goswamis and Mirabai, Kameti Bai, both came to establish the glories of Braj. Ramanuja, Acharya and Adi Shankara, there's no reference when they could have visited Braj. Balabhacharya, he was after Mahaprabhu, another great sage, established Braj Mandal, established Natatwar, and is the leader of Pushti Marga, which has captured entire Gujarat area with loving and serving Krishna. Vital Nath, he did parikrama also from Maharashtra, a very famous Vaishnava saint. Rasa Khan, a follower of Balabhacharya, became a famous Muslim saint turned into a Vaishnava saint and poet, Rasa Khan. Taj, Muslim lady, Taj is a famous lady, a Muslim lady who became a devotee and sang songs for Krishna from Karoli. Then Bhaktamal mentions Naba, another Braj saint. Revival of modern parikrama from all over India was done 1932 by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada. The majority of nations were introduced to the parikrama of Braj under the invitation of Swami Bhaktivedanta Prabhupada F. W. Groves from the Mathura Gazetteer gives the evidence of how Brajmandal was a connected, interconnected place. He was a British district magistrate, but a very cultured person. Only Braj was not submerged in water when Hiranyaksha tried to drown the earth. It's mentioned when the earth was put under water, only Brajmandal stayed above. When Pralaya will destroy everything, Brajmandal is told to stay, being part of Goloka. Now, whether you can understand that, or you just believe it, because the Shastras, they say that. So these are the reasons how we presented to the government why they should make Brajmandala Parikrama. They should do that, and also as for the United Nations to establish. So this is all Vrindakunja homework. No, so in this way you can understand there's something going on. That's one of the reasons I spent more time in India, have less time to visit all the temples all over, or invite people in different moments to come and meet me here. One of the devotees said yesterday, devotees sometimes complaining that I can't come all the time to them. And the devotee said, the devotees should get accustomed. If they want to have some association, then they should go there where I am. Find out, it's on the itinerary, and then make your journey there. Or if you cannot come, do something fantastic on behalf of Sri Vrindavan Dham, Srila Prabhupada, wherever you are. And it is just as good as visiting. When you do the work which has to be done, it's just as good as visiting. Those who take initiation today, please fast in the morning. We will do the initiation in the morning time. And then we wait for sun for a little yajna. Because we cannot do yajna inside here, so we have to wait for a glimpse of sun, which could also be tomorrow if the sun is gonna hide too much today. Anyhow, this is just to keep you updated what is going on there, no? I am... very, very happy to share all these things with you. So you know what's going on in Colombia, what's going on in India, and then, of course, Gurudev Atulananda, he is doing wonderful things all over, now in Chile. So it's just like, the other day we were counting, after the beginning of the eco farms and all that idea of bringing people into nature and celebrating spiritual nature, we have something like 84 farms connected to the Vrinda family. Not all of them owned by the Vrinda family, but connected to the spirit of wanting to do such a thing. And the natives are so surprised. They think, how in the world did the Vrinda family is looking after the centuries? We're looking after the century of Mama Yuka in La Serena. This is a Diaguita sanctuary. We are looking in Incahuara. We are looking after the sanctuary of those local Aymaras. In Coroico, we are looking after the sanctuary of Ushumachi. That is the sacred mountain of the Aymaras. Amazing place. In Tena, Ecuador, we're looking after the sanctuary of the jungles of the culture, Quechua culture, just in front of the Janganatis. Janganatis, this is something else. Janganatis is an unpenetrable mountain range, which not even the colonialists normally is going, it says that Atahualpa caves are in there. The treasures are kept, amazing. The Jagannath is in our farm, is just on the entrance to the Jagannath is on one side, and Vrindavan Hardin Ecologico on the other side. And on the entrance to there, there's one devotee, she has a big farm on 3,600 meter elevation called Rishikesh. And that place is, I don't know what's gonna happen there, but it's just, it's full of hot springs. And just recently we were informed last year that the government or the indigenous people are giving our own hot water. We have our own 80 degrees hot water coming from the Antisana. The Antisana is a volcano right behind that place, and that has lots of hot water coming from there. So we are getting our own hot springs so we can make like our own bath facility, because in that area there is a lot of that. In Colombia, in Santa Marta, there is the sanctuary called the healing ponds of the Kogis and Arawakos and Wiwas. That was discovered inside our Goloka farm. Then, next to Gambira, the University of the Tairona culture was discovered, only 2 kilometers walk from our farm, whereas the education of those, the Utsav, the University of Ancient Wisdom headquarters. That is an amazing thing because it's all carved into the rocks. The anti-wisdom of the natives is carved there. And it said that it will be revealed what it really means when all the people would start working together. Because they put this there when the colonialists were like putting the indigenous people down and they had to escape out into the high mountains. It's amazing. When you see that, your hair stand on end. What they did there. That's another native place. So wherever you go, I see Krishna has put us, like in Medellin, the devotees are custodians of the Nutivara natives, one of the rock formations, also very amazing and beautiful. And that was discovered. When we got this farm, we didn't know it existed. It was all under bushes. And then we started, there was water coming out, and we started cleaning out the bushes and these rock formations and caves started. Nobody knew that. So, same thing in Varshana, I told you, the Muisca sanctuary. And so, for some reason, Krishna has positioned the devotees in sanctuary locations. And because these people, for them, the nature sanctuary is like their main church. So therefore, there's a very close communication between Krishna and his devotees and the natives, and this has produced an amazing, beautiful conjunction, because it helps us to bring new light to humanity, in the sense that the true values of love can be extracted conjointly by the oldest culture of the East and the West, and that together should bring about some impact in the hearts of the mestizos, the mixtures, all the people in the white world, Europe, America, and there's all. We all mix up, we don't have much of a tradition alive. But we also see the disasters of the world and the difficulties. So it's about time to wake up and search our roots to protect our roots. And that is just the tip of the iceberg. I can't say more because the time will run and also you get saturated with so much information, but this is what's the reality of this world. And we are not mentioned the Maya connections in Guatemala, which is very intense with the Maya cultures. In Mexico, very intense connection with the natives, the Wichollis, and very connected with the culture of the Algonquin tribes of Canada, North America, Lakota, the connection with the Lakota pipeline and all that. So there's much work to be done, you know, much of tying and time. I think in 2019, you will see the most surprising manifestation in the Kumbh Mela ever seen. It will manifest there. I have a feeling Krishna is lining it up into that direction. How exactly, we don't know yet, but we want all the holy rivers to be there. Get ready, Mrs. Daniel, and Tigris and all these, Oda, all these beautiful rivers we're going to have all dancing in with Ganga and Yamuna and Saraswati. And the native chiefs and of course so many other devotees and friends will come, and it will be an amazing meeting for the rights of Mother Earth that will be on the agenda, and the holy rivers of the world also will be on the agenda. That will be the two main agendas, but the real agenda is increasing the loving network for protecting Mother Earth. So that is going on by even just lining up these things, protecting or trying to organize them. There's a lot of these connections already taking place. So if you mark it February 2019 and some extra savings necessary, because that will be about the price of 1,000 euros for that whole month in India. Plus your ticket to go there. It will be about to be able to host and organize everything very nicely.
Haribol.
And if anybody wants to sponsor a native chief of his area, please organize it locally, because we won't have big sponsorship of a big organization. Has to be lots of sponsorships locally also. Like if a Sami leader wants to go or anything like that. Do you have any questions? Are you going to be there, Mahahari?
Say yes.
We have to bring some of our grandfathers also. Yes.
Gurudev, how many workers for Vrindavanak now are there so far?
So far, I think, because we are also doing Mayapur, I think right now we are like 35. And our volunteers also go out, the devotees also go out. So 35 is probably the number.
So we need 10 times more. But we need 10 times more.
Yeah.
That's ideal.
Yeah, to get all of Braj Mandal into the system. At some point, I think government will take over. When they see the whole thing working, they'll say, well, we can do it. I mean, it's not my goal that we have to send money to India all the time for the future. But if we do, it doesn't matter. It's a little gift for all what we received from India. We got so much grace coming from Bharatavarsha, so to send some financial help there for this type of excellent project, it can only be glorious for our savings to go to a good place and not to be spent on some stupid cruise ship or something like that.
The government supports this. The government in India supports this. The organization that spread the 2 million prasadams per day, they get funding from government also.
Yes.
So they can.
It's a different law. By a different law, this was arranged.
But it's possible.
And everything is possible. But when something gets big and governmental, then I move out. Because it's not my job, then other people can look after that. I'm just trying to get it going, injecting the... Because our personal lifestyle is really looking after individuals, not after legal proceedings.